Have you ever had a conversation with somebody and said, I'll pray for you? It's always in the future tense, right? Well, I had an opportunity not long ago to go to a retreat at Mary Immaculate Parish over in Farmers Branch here in north of Dallas. It's called Holy Spirit 101. And the purpose of this retreat was really to help teach the participants how to use intercessory prayer when they're praying with people. And it was really a powerful opportunity. And I just want to share with you an opportunity that I probably would have never done if I hadn't have been through this retreat. I was driving in one of these drizzly, rainy days here in the Fort Worth area, and the little light came on my dashboard that said I had a low tire. And it was real cold, it had just gotten cold, so I thought, okay, I need to get it to. Well, I'm driving by a discount tire store, and they have a line set up, and there was no line there, but they had a line set up that you could pull in and they would check your air for you. So I knew I needed it, so I whipped in there real quick, and this gentleman came walking up in order to take care of it for me. I rolled down my window, and he said, how you doing? I said, I'm blessed. And he said, you took the words right out of my mouth. And then he went around and he did my tires, he filled them up and he checked them, and he came back to the window, and I don't know why, but he just started opening his life up to me. But you know, I say I don't know why, he'd had some really tough things happening in his family very, very recently. He'd had a niece and a nephew who both came down with cancer at about the same time. This was like in the last couple of weeks. And they were at a family event, and this gentleman I was talking to and his wife, he said they're the only ones that have a spiritual life. You know, they're the only ones that are praying, going to church and that kind of thing. And I don't know what church he goes to, a Christian church it seemed like of some sort. But he said, I was trying to share with my 6-7 brothers and sisters and their spouses and these people that, you know, this you need to pray, you need to come back to the Lord. And they were all raised in a faith, but none of the others are practicing. So he was trying to use this as an opportunity to help them. And he said, you know, maybe you know your children are having this problem because they're trying. The Lord's trying to talk to you. So he's spilling all this stuff out, sitting at an airline, okay, at a discount tire store. So I let him talk, and I just said to him, I said, you want to pray? And he kind of looked at me, and he said, yeah, that'd be nice. So I reached out the window, we grasped hands, and you know I just thought about the Holy Spirit, and I said, Holy Spirit, what do you want me to say with this gentleman who's hurting and his family's hurting? And I said a prayer with him, and it was probably 2 minutes long. I can't even tell you what I said. I don't care what I said, because I was just listening to the Holy Spirit and letting him guide that conversation, trying to help bring peace to him and his family, and trying to give him some message that he could take back to those of his family that are hurting. And we finished. He said, thank you. He was very thankful. And I started driving off, and he said, hey, are you a preacher or something? I said, no way, sir. I'm just another brother in Christ. So when someone asks and they're telling you their problems, don't say, I will say a prayer for you. Just say, let's pray about that. And take a minute to do it. It'll make a huge difference in their life and yours.